and Al Qaeda. Foreign Minister, thanks very much for joining us. Will the Pakistani military go into that tribal area along the border with Afghanistan and crush the Taliban and Al Qaeda?
The Pakistani military is already there in the tribal area. We had 85,000 earlier. Two divisions have been sent recently in the tribal areas and in some other areas adjoining the tribal areas. Pakistan's commitment cannot be doubted by anybody, and that is why some of our people do not like what we read in some of your newspapers, which are more like leaks and calculated leaks. And we hear of soft, you know, safe havens in Pakistan. It really makes us very angry when we are suffering so many casualties, when our troops are suffering so many casualties. I know you're a friend, but the way you frame your question is something that people in Pakistan don't like.
Here's what the National Intelligence Estimate, Foreign Minister, that the Bush administration released this past week said. It said, we assess Al-Qaeda has protected or regenerated key elements of its homeland attack capability, including a safe haven in the Pakistan federally administered tribal areas, operational lieutenants, and its top leadership. And the president's national security advisor, Stephen Hadley, said that the plan that you had in the works for most of the past year simply failed. Listen to what Hadley said.
And the truth is, it did not work. And what we've seen, pooling of Taliban, training, operational planning.
It's not just leaks. These are official statements from the U.S. government, including the president's national security advisor. So the question is, what do you do now?
Okay, Wolf, here's my response. You're quoting me a national intelligence estimate. Is that what it's called?
Yes.
Yes. Now, and against an estimate, we have the 9/11 Commission report, which was a bipartisan commission report. It took stock of the entire situation, and it came to a conclusion that would be completely counterproductive if, as we are hearing in American newspapers, and that's what I meant by leaks, that there are some people are talking irresponsibly of attacks in the tribal areas of Pakistan by the United States. And that's what I had in mind. After all, one is supposed to pay a much, much greater attention to the 9/11 Commission report, which is a bipartisan report, which takes into consideration all the intelligence that they had. And in fact, the best, your think tanks could produce, and I think their deliberations lasted over months. All I'm saying is this. I'm not trying to underestimate the situation. I know it's a difficult situation. We've suffered casualties in the last 3 days. What we need is actionable intelligence. We do not want, you know, something said just for the purpose of having an effect on American public opinion. Now, I want to say one thing very clearly. The whole purpose of this exercise to win hearts and minds of the people. Now, we are aware of that, and we have to carry our public opinion with us. And here is a figure which I'd like you and the American audience to ponder over. Look at the ratio of casualties between your troops and Iraqi civilians. And do you know what our casualties have been? When 500 or 600 of our soldiers died, and I'm talking the past year, not the recent ones, we were able to get hold of about 800 or 900 fatalities by the militants, which means the ratio is 1 to 1.2, whereas the ratio in Iraq, I do not wish to mention. The difference is that we cannot afford what is conveniently called collateral damage. We are committed to controlling terrorism. We have demonstrated that at the time of Lal Masjid recently, mosque, and it lasted over 6 months. We tried our best to save lives. It was only as a last resort that force was used. And people in Pakistan get very upset when, despite all the sacrifices that Pakistan has been making, you know, you have the sort of questions that are sometimes asked by the American media. And as far as the media is concerned, I don't wish to be more frank than I'm going to be in this interview. We heard a lot of what was said before the Iraq war. A lot of newspapers now have been gracious enough to admit that they made certain mistakes. Maybe they are making bigger mistakes at this moment.
So basically, are you questioning the U.S. intelligence community's assessment that Al-Qaeda and the Taliban have
No, I am not questioning anything. No, I am not questioning. When there are friends, you don't question. What I don't like is the tone. that I am now hearing and that I am now reading in the American media. And as far as that is concerned, I wish to make it very clear that Pakistan is committed. So what one wants is not simply, you know, some estimates. One wants very targeted, one wants evidence, actionable intelligence. Let the United States provide us with actionable intelligence, and you will find that Pakistan will never be lacking.
I want you to listen, Foreign Minister, to the President's Homeland Security Advisor, Fran Townsend, who made it clear that if the U.S. had actionable intelligence on the whereabouts of Osama bin Laden, the U.S. would strike, even if it meant striking targets inside Pakistan. Listen to Fran Townsend.
There's no question, the President's made perfectly clear, if we had actionable targets anywhere in the world, putting aside whether it was Pakistan or any place else, we would pursue those targets.
Is that acceptable to your government, Foreign Minister?
Well, I would like to make it clear. Pakistan Army is one of the most organized armies in the world. It's one of the largest armies in the world. It has a track record prior to First World War. What we can do, nobody can do better. So if you have superiority in technical intelligence, please share that with us. And when you talk of going after targets, you will lose the battle for hearts and minds. It is much better to rely on Pakistan Army. Pakistan Army can do the job much better, and the result will be that there will be far less collateral damage, as I tried to prove by the figures that I have earlier given during my interview.
One final question, Foreign Minister, before I let you go. How would you describe the U.S.-Pakistani relationship right now?
It's very good, and I say with authority, because I deal with the highest American officials who meet me frequently. People who meet the President, people who meet the Prime Minister, people who meet me. We have so many congressional delegations that visit Pakistan. We have so many high American officials that visit Pakistan. And all I would like to ask through you, Wolf, is for the American public to realize that Pakistan has been in the front line. It has suffered major casualties, and we would like those to be acknowledged. We quite appreciate when you give a lot of time to American soldiers who died in Iraq and Afghanistan. I think there'd be far greater understanding if you devoted one-tenth of the space to the casualties that Pakistan is suffering. And I think American media and American public would then much better understand the sacrifices that Pakistan has made. Our commitment is total, but this war, or whatever you would like to call it, can only be won if we have hearts and minds on our side and not the other way around.
Khurshid Kasuri is the Foreign Minister of Pakistan. Foreign Minister, thanks for joining us on Late Edition.
It's a pleasure to be with you, as always, Wolf.